129 people dead in Paris from the attacks on Friday night. You've heard from a student, a Jersey student who was there, a Jersey parent who was on the phone. We've got, there was a roundup in Paris. At least two, maybe three suspected terrorists are dead. Another seven in custody. Millions of displaced Syrians, ISIS, a lot going on in the world. I thought what struck me this morning when Eric Scott was talking about the news that there were 17 Muslim leaders in New Jersey who condemned the attack in Paris. My initial gut instinct was that, how is that news? Like, what? Of course they condemned the attack. They're living in Jersey. You know, the idea here is, and my question has been, where has been the condemnation of some of the practices that take place in Muslim countries around the world that has inevitably led to a lot of fear among people in Europe, people in America? And whether or not you agree with this whole thing with the Syrian refugees, there's no question that most people that I talk to and have heard from, callers, etc., will say, look, a pause is probably the best idea when you don't know. You know, the old saying, my wife says this, when in doubt, leave it out. Well, if we have any doubts about our vetting process, then better to err on the side of safety. Now, I'm joined by Imam Hamad Shebli. Imam Hamad has been the head of, he's an imam from South Brunswick. Imam Hamad, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.
Good morning.
Thanks for joining me. I appreciate you taking the time. You're the head of the Islamic Society of Central Jersey.
You are right. I am the religious director of the Islamic Society of Central Jersey, located in South Brunswick between Trenton and New Brunswick since 1983, officially as a full-time imam as a clergy since 1985.
So here's the question I have for you. I was not surprised, nor am I impressed, that there were Muslim leaders that came out and condemned Paris. Pretty much the entire civilized world condemned what happened in Paris. The question I have to you is, I would like your take as a religious leader, as a Muslim religious leader, on what do you say to Muslims in New Jersey, and what do you say to people that are at this moment very concerned about the future and ISIS, etc.? What do you say?
Let me divide your question for a three part, and I thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak loudly, more than what we did yesterday in Rutgers and five outlets of newspapers and new television visit me yesterday in the Islamic Center of Central Jersey for the whole day. Number one, for the Muslim who are living in New Jersey, number one, they are American. Number two, they pay the tax. Number three, they love their country. Number four, we have to be a better citizen every day, better than the day before. And we thank God we were able to go through all the difficulties since Oklahoma, September 11, and all this things that happened. And we have been condemned all the bad things, and we enjoy and encourage the people to do the good things. Number two, related to the Muslim countries who are keep silent, not to stand up on their feet, from president to kings to princes to Ayatollah to anybody, talk about Islam in overseas, it is a time right now to stand up for the right of the human being, regardless who are they. In the eyes of God, there is no American, no European, no Arab, no non-Arab. All of us.
Imam Hamad, let me just ask you though about that. And yes. But there are nations, and there are national interests, and there are civilizations, and civilization is now under attack by radicals. And here's my question: where does this start? How do you separate the religion from the act? Because I'm looking, like, right in the Quran, there is a statement about, and kill them wherever you find them, and turn them out from where they have turned you out.
We have been living with this quotation since day one. And don't forget, in the Bible, in the Torah, you have the same meaning of those quotations, but we should not cut it off from the beginning and the end of why God revealed those three verses in the Bible, in the Torah, and the Quran. And we should not, slice the religion. we take what we like.
But let me ask you, though, on that point, it's not the Jews and the Christians that are forming terrorist groups that are going and blowing up restaurants or shooting people with AK-47s. How is it that it has become so twisted that people are using this and they're now acting on it?
I am not blaming neither a Christian or a Jews or a good Muslim. I am blaming the person who switched the switch of the religion and to try to apply the religion according to his or her understanding to kill the others. Religion will never ever encourage any human being to hurt an ant or a cut of trees or destroy a house or kill a human being. But some of the bad ones, and I hope through your channel and your radio and your listening, to say, let us separate the people from the religion. Religion is a religion, and bad one is a bad one. As a God never ever revealed a book to those individuals, regardless who are they. God revealed the book to Muhammad and to Jesus and to Moses, does not reveal this book to the people who misunderstanding and they want to put the religion to be blamed, so, not only from today, but from day one.
So do you agree, though, that it is time for the moderate Muslims, who are clearly a great majority of the 1.6 billion Muslims across the globe, to stand up and oppose what is happening, even in their countries in the Middle East? I mean, how do you wrap your head around a young Muslim who asks you, why is it that an adulterer can be stoned to death in Muslim countries?
Believe me, I am dealing with this issue every day. I wish you visit me in the mosque. We deal with it with more than 2,000 students, 600 students, a full-time school. They graduate from Nur-Liman School and they go to the best university. We have Saturday and Sunday school. I deal with them every day or every week. We talk about this and we try to tell them religion has nothing to do with the bad action that people are taking it. And we clarify that to them. We did not cut one verse, and we leave 636 verses in the Quran, all of it honor a human being, not from today, but from the day of Adam. And I will give you two examples, if you allowed me. We have been celebrating the Thanksgiving every year in South Brunswick through the South Brunswick Clergy Association, Muslim, Christian, Hindu, Sikh, in all our life since 1985 till today. And next week, I invite you with your team to come to the synagogue in Finnegan Lane to attend with us November 22nd, 7 o'clock, to attend the Thanksgiving with the youth, with everybody, to stand up together as a human being.
At the synagogue. In New Jersey, Imam. I love that. There's going to be a joint service.
This is America. This is New Jersey. We are not living in any other part of the world.
Well, Imam Hamad, I've got to take a break for traffic and weather, but I do appreciate your time. Thank you for your honest, forthright answers, and we will hopefully we'll be able to have some attendance at that event.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity, and please say hello to all your team, and we're listening to your radio almost 24 hours, if you believe me or not.
Imam Hamad, I do believe you, and I appreciate you listening, and thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.